When the tenant moves out or the landlord moves on, it's time to pay back the security deposits payable. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. It's very simple to record paying back the security deposits to tenants or landlords. Simply record one payment in the checks window. Make sure you choose the security deposit liability or payables account instead of the rent payout balances account like we learned in prior videos. It's one entry. That's it. For example, let's imagine on March 17, Candy moves out and requests her security deposit back. In this example, we will imagine that she is not responsible for any of the March rent, because sometimes that happens. Check the tenant security deposit report to see how much we pay back and why. In this example, you can see that part of her security deposit was applied to a past expense. So if I come over here to QuickBooks and I open up the tenant security deposit payable, when I look specifically in the section of Candy, I can see that she did give us a security deposit on March 1, but then on March 4th we had an expense that was applied to the security deposit, and we can even double click and we can even show her this invoice and mark it as a paid invoice for the supplies that she cost us. And we could even go back to the original check if we need to. Or we can isolate the dates for this report and then filter it by just Candy like we learned before in order to give her a report that explains why Candy is only getting $650 when we refund her security deposit and not the entire $1,000. So if we agree that she will get the net amount with a printed security deposit report, from the amount on the report, $650, then the question is, what will happen when we pay? Well, the tenant's cash deposit trust account, which physically holds the money, will decrease because the money is coming from the special bank account that we set aside for security deposits and being given back to the tenant. And of course, the tenant's security deposit liability payables account will also decrease because that's supposed to show the balance of what we owe back to the tenants. And of course, we no longer owe the tenant the security deposit because we're paying it back today. So what will happen in the trial balance when we pay back Candy's security deposit? Well, the tenant's security deposit, which shows the balance of what we owe back to the tenants, will decrease by $650 and become $3,000 because we owe $650 less because we're paying back now. And of course, the account that physically holds the tenant's cash will decrease by $650 and become $3,350 because we're physically taking this money and giving it back to the tenant. So, how do we record this? Well, it's very simple. We can click the check window, and the date was March 17th of 2022, and the tenant we're paying is Candy under Alan Arby. The amount we're paying is $650. As per the report, now be very careful. The account you choose in the bottom left, in the top, you have to make sure actually that you're physically taking the money from the tenant's cash deposit bank account, click OK, and then the account that reflects what we owe back to tenants, which is the tenant security deposit, goes in the bottom of the window. So the money is coming from the special bank account to pay off the liability. And that's the way to think about it. Then when we click save and close, we open the trial balance and you can see the results are exactly as what we expected. The tenant's security deposit went down to $3,000 and the tenant's cash deposit decreased to $3,350. However, the most important report to check is the tenant security deposit report. You can now see that for specifically candy, we now owe zero and we will pay back zero after this $650 check. And her balance in the security deposit report for this specific tenant is now zero. Now let's see what happens when we pay back a landlord their deposit. Let's imagine on March 18, Dave the landlord is no longer our client. He requires his landlord security deposit back, which we called the operating deposit. He will receive the net amount as per the landlord deposit report. So let's take a look at the landlord deposit report. If we come here, you can look at Dave Deeney and you see Dave is not getting $2,000 back for his security deposit. Dave is only getting $1,300 back for his security deposit. And you can isolate Dave by filtering by name like we learned so that the report only shows Dave, and you can print it and give it to him and that will explain why. You can even double click and print the invoice as a paid invoice applied against the deposit and it will show him the reason. And if he really wants proof, you can go back to the original check and print him a copy of the actual receipt that you got when you paid. But either way, he's only getting $1,300. So what will happen at the moment we pay? Well, the cash in bank will decrease because we know that that is the bank account that we chose to physically hold the landlord's deposit. So we know that the money is coming from the operating bank account. And of course, the landlord's operating deposit will decrease because that account represents what we owe, and we no longer owe the landlord the deposit if at this moment we are paying it back. So what will happen in the trial balance at the moment we pay back the landlord's security deposit? Well, the landlord operating deposit decreases by $1,300. So right now it's $3,300. It will become $2,000 because if we pay, we no longer owe $1,300 to that particular landlord. And of course, the bank account will decrease by $1,300 because that's where the money's coming from, and it will become $4,450. And we pay it back exactly the same way we paid back the tenant security deposit. We click the check. This time it's the 18th, and we have to make sure that the money is coming from the bank account that it was originally put in. In the case of the landlord, we use the operating bank account. Just click OK. And the amount we're paying, $1,300. Now be very careful. We must choose only the landlord and not any of the tenants under the landlord. And of course, the account down here is the liability account. Landlord's operating deposit. That's it. That's all you have to put. When we click save and close, we can check the trial balance and you can see the results are exactly as what we expected. the landlord operating deposit decreased to $2,000, and the operating account cash and bank decreased to $4,450. And to be absolutely sure that everything is correct, you should check the landlord operating deposit report, where you can see we owe Dave Deeney nothing. And the reason we owe him nothing is because it shows this check that we paid him on the 18th for the $1,300 balance.